think the way I cope with them is by like, you've got to realize how attached some people can get because they are seeing you, they're watching, you're part of their daily routine for a long period of time. Like people get easily attached to things anyway, never mind people. So when it's people and you're seeing them every day for a long period of time, I think you've got to understand that they are interested. So even when you aren't feeling the best maybe and you can't really be bothered sometimes, you've got to make that effort because it's nice and they're the people that give you the opportunities that we've got right now.
Mm. I think for me, it's always kind of making sure you're grounded in the sense that like you're knowing your family and your friends support you and keeping that kind of sense of normality still, because I think it's really easy to get wrapped up in everything. And like obviously now we've got this whole group of friends who are all going through the same thing as us, and as great as that is, I'm still making sure that I'm not neglecting like my old friends who were the ones who were there for me before any of this. And I think that kind of helps me deal with the pressure and just makes me remember kind of like who they know me as.
Yeah, I think it's this sounds really weird, but normal things that you did before like help you get help reality, sort of like you stay grounded, as in like cooking for yourself. Everybody will give us anything and everything for free right now, but actually like going to the shops for normal stuff and like actually going and doing our own stuff that we would do before that, like going to the gym, like going and like it's weird, isn't it, like stuff that you would do before that where it's not everybody around you will do every little thing for you, but I would never want to take advantage of that.
For me, positive things are, I suppose, like making sure I feel good, as well as like looking good is one thing for like the press and stuff, but actually feeling good in myself. So like making sure that like I take some time just to like, even things like going through my wardrobe and just making sure like I love all the things that I'm going to be wearing and seeing. And for me, that kind of helps me feel good, as well as making sure like I look good for all the things I'm going to be getting up to in the week.
I think that whether the people around you definitely like rely on the people that were there for you before, because I think when you're in the limelight, you soon realise who's with you and who's not, even if they like from what they've previously acted like. Like Zara is a big one for me. Whether she realises that or not, I probably have timeouts for my phone, which she doesn't realise, and I just solely am with her and no one else. Or, for example, other people who, like my family and stuff like that. So I think that's good. Like, dropping the phone is definitely something we're trying to do now and then.
He always tells me off. He's like, put it down. For me, it's probably my mum or Adam, just because I feel like my mum understands me and knows me better than anyone and can give me some really good advice. But then sometimes you need someone who's in the same, going through the same thing as you, to like almost rationalize it with you. And sometimes, yeah, where I feel like my mum may not understand the huge pressure that I'm under, Adam can come through in that way.
I think for me as well, there's a couple. There's my dad, because he knows us better than anyone. But I think speaking to other islanders as well, this sounds quite bad, but when I speak to other islanders and think that maybe I'm not coping with things as well, when I speak to them, I think that I'm probably a little bit more thick-skinned than they actually are. So I almost feel like if I'm good, especially for me, I think as long as I act fine, Zara will be fine. Like, I get more wound up about stuff that people say about her. I don't even look at my stuff. It doesn't bother us at all anymore. It did when I first came out, but right now, I would always make sure she was fine before me, I think. I think no one could be top, because I don't think anyone could be a 13, possibly, because there is always one little thing that gets to someone. And there's always certain times of the day or certain times of the month or certain times of the year where you're going to go through periods where you struggle with something, but how you bounce back from that is always what shows. So maybe, I personally think now that I'm used to it at 12, because I think that we've learned recently, like especially the last few weeks, I think it's toughened us both up for life.
Yeah, I think for me, yeah, I agree. I don't think anyone's like 100% perfect, but I personally don't struggle with anxiety or depression or anything like that. And I think obviously some people are more like at risk to it, like in a biological sense than others. And I think I'm quite fortunate in the fact that perhaps I'm not, and perhaps I do deal with things well, but there are some things that I know I don't deal with well. So I don't personally deal with people like attacking me on social media. That's my one kind of hang up. I don't deal with that very well. A lot of other things I can deal with, but that is the one thing I can't deal with. So yeah, probably I'd say maybe a 10.
But Zara 4 weeks, how long have we been on for? 8 weeks?
Yeah.
The first 4 weeks compared to Zara and the second 4 weeks is amazing to see the difference, because you learn quick, don't you?
Yeah.
I think mental health issues probably start from bullying quite a lot. I think people don't understand how one comment can stick with someone for such a long time.
But I also think that maybe those people who do bully are the ones with the mental health problems,
yeah.
Because I feel like those people are the ones who potentially can't understand and empathise how it feels to be bullied. And I think that those specifically are the people that like campaigns and stuff need to target more so than those who are victims, because these people are kind of like the perpetrators of bullying. And I think that these people, that I see them all the time on social media, and like me with a, I think I've got quite a rational mind, can't understand how someone thinks that's okay. And I think we need to kind of change the norm on that and make people realise, no, that's not okay. And those people who are bullying, potentially they do have some kind of issue that needs to be resolved in some way. So I think, yeah, I think bullying does affect people's mental health, but I think it starts with someone, and I think that's the person we need to be looking at.
No one used to see all those, like when your mum used to say the bully in school is always the one who's been bullied or something like that. I think with social media being such a big thing, it's like that, but on a massive scale.
Yeah.
The person calling you, I don't even know what they're using as an
like
example.
Like ugly or...
Yeah, like for example, for me, like the people who are in the fitness industry and who are really, really like idols of mine support me more than the people who probably are at day one and probably need a little bit of help with it. So it's weird, isn't it? It's that whole thing where like, oh, the boy at school's bullying us, or well, he fancies you or something. Like that's what my mum always used to say to my little sister and stuff like that. Yeah. It's the same as that.
I think it feels, for me, it's just like disappointing. Like I look at the person, I'm just like, why are you spending your free time? We have a limited time on this earth. Why are you spending it like attacking me? You don't know me, you know, like attacking people over things they can't change. So like things like, you know, my body and my face and things like that. It's like it's things that are so personal. And also I think, I mean, I remember being, not being in the public eye, and seeing Charles comment and thinking, oh, you know, that celebrity probably never sees it. No, I've never comment myself ever, but seeing it done, thinking, no one will ever see it. But the reality is like celebrities do see it. Like you see pretty much every single comment. Like if you look hard enough, of course you can see everything. Like, you know, I am guilty of spending my days scrolling through my comments. Like,
yeah.
Whoa, why has this person said this? Oh my God. And like my heart almost sinks, because I'm like, oh my God, why have they said that about me? Like I thought my foot was the right shape, but apparently it's not. And like things like that. You're just like, why is someone trolling me over that? And like, I suppose when you're out of it, and my mum and dad are always just like, why do you let it get to you? And it's like, when it's repeated, you just kind of think, why me? Like, why am I having to be a victim of this? And why am I having to put up with it? Like, the amount of people that I've met through this whole experience in shopping centres or on the street or in airports, no one has ever said anything negative to my face. So why is it okay that 50% of the people that comment on my posts is negative?
Yeah, that's a big one. I think the ones that surprise me are the direct or aesthetic ones, where it's about some direct part of you, the way you look.
Yeah.
Like, almost, if it was something about the show or the way you acted on the show, it's still bad, but it's a little slightly, it's slightly more relatable.
Yeah, because you can understand it's edited.
Yeah, because you don't know what they've seen, because I haven't been able to watch them all. Like, we haven't possibly got the time, so I don't know what someone might have seen and took the wrong way around. So it's still bad, and I think if you've got nothing good to say, you shouldn't really say it. 99% of the time that's the correct way to be. But the direct like stuff about the way we look or something like that, like I think that's the ones that are really bad.
So within the next couple months, my main aim is to go in and talk to students in schools about not only my experience, but hopefully educate kids about how to kind of better treat your peers in a way, how, you know, someone like me can still be affected by, you know, trolling, bullying. And I suppose my experiences from when I was younger, I had a lot of experiences with bullying in various instances that I'm sure a lot of people have seen in the press. And I just think the way that I've come out of the other side of that is almost like I've learned ways to deal with things. I think that other people could learn and learn from me, I hope. And you know, take kind of inspiration from the fact that I've moved on from such a horrible, dark time in my life to something quite positive, and hopefully I can turn it around and do something positive with it by going into these schools. But yeah, I mean, I try and respond to as many people as I can on Instagram. I get so many messages from girls and boys all going through very similar kind of things that I went through, and I try and respond to as many as I can and give sound advice.
I think it would be a good idea to try and maybe tell people in similar sort of situations that we've been through, like coping mechanisms would be good, because I think a lot of people go through it, but seeing people that are on Love Island that are probably a little bit more relatable than someone coming into school that's probably a lot older trying to preach it at them.
Yeah.
They don't relate to it as much. Like, whereas, I mean,
eight weeks ago,
someone would have walked past us on the street, or would have, do you know what I mean? Like, we would have been the same. And I think it would be good for people to see that. Yeah, they're always there for life, I think, isn't
yeah.
it?
Yeah. Funny enough, I got a text from one of the producers this morning saying, if you want to book in with new doctor, medical person, you're more than welcome to, let us know. So they're always there. We've always got the psychologist's number, and she checks in every now and again to make sure we're okay. And if anything comes out in the press as well, they're really good. They pick up on it straight away and give you a call. So, you know, they're really good. They are, you can't even fault their.
And that's not just Zara, something doesn't have to happen. Like, they're not generic messages, but they're messages that everyone
yeah.
will get.
Yeah.
Like, we're not saying like, oh, it's just Zara.
Yeah, but everyone's obviously got a message today, but almost
like,
people
get it. I get FaceTime, like I've been FaceTimed off people who were there, just literally just making sure you're okay. And the producers, like, and stuff like that, you weirdly make quite good friends with them.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, yeah. I think the main thing to remember nowadays is what's happening is the percentage of young people with mental illness is increasing. Now, you can look at it in two ways. Is the diagnosis actually increasing because there's more people with mental illness, or is it increasing because there's more people being recognised as having it? So it's not changed, it's always been there, just are more people being diagnosed now because we've got more methods of, you know, recognising. So I think there's some key piece of work to be done there to look at, you know, what is causing this, but also having someone to talk to in school. I mean, I know that I had a mental first aider in school, and I used to go and speak to her all the time. She was fantastic. It was just so good to have someone kind of like impartial. And also, coping mechanisms are so important. Like, I studied psychology, and just from doing that, I learned so many ways, and I could help others as well. So yeah, I think it would be one of the best decisions that people can make, because at the end of the day, when you're a young adult, you're formulating who you are going to become when you are an adult. And if you can kind of combat that mental illness whilst you're developing, I think it would kind of pay off. It will pay off so much better in later life for those young adults.
Guys, it's important to look after your physical fitness.
But it's also important to look after your mental health. So make sure you sign up to our campaign.